Hey folks, it's Jang here from UltimateRC.com, and this is my full-on review of the Axial Exo Terra Buggy. Now, I generally hold to the belief that everyone has a right to their own opinions, but if you think that this buggy right here doesn't look amazing, well, your opinion is just wrong. Seriously, I mean, look at it. It's an amazing replica of a modern four-seat pre-runner buggy. What the short course craze did for RC trucks, this does for buggies. Even small little details that aren't really required are included, and all wrapped up in a very solid and intricate roll cage. The light bar on the roof is even set up to accept real LEDs, though the LEDs aren't included. And check this out, interior detail. It's not full depth, it doesn't go all the way down, but it is there and it does look really good. They even have some details for the dash. Where's my steering wheel and driver figure? Wheels and tires, realistic again, with actual licensed Hankook DynaPro MT treads. These are compatible with 10th scale short course wheels and tires, though the fronts here are a little bit on the narrow side. I've got a whole video detailing more about that. When you look from the underside though, it's all business. It uses a very narrow aluminum stamped chassis, hard anodized with all countersunk hardware, with lightweight plastic wings along the sides that go right out to hug the edges of the body panels to seal out dirt. The suspension design is pretty traditional, with just A-arms on the bottom and adjustable turnbuckle camber links up top, and they give you most of the adjustability through mounting holes and the like that you would find in a full-on race rig. To take a look at the chassis from the top side though, I'm gonna have to start my stopwatch and share with you some pain. Yeah, you heard that right. Pain. After removing the rear wheels, it's 16 long self-tapping screws to get the upper roll cage assembly extricated from the chassis, and that's 16 screws in 5 different sizes. Thankfully, they at least all use the same driver. In the process, you have to disconnect your upper front shock mounts and your lower rears. All this was just shown at 8 times normal speed, plus I used a drill for a driver on high speed. After all that, I'm finally able to get this whole thing off, and it only took, that's not that bad, 3.5 minutes. Only problem is that I have to do this anytime I want to access anything on the chassis. Trust me, it gets old fast. Now, looking at what's left of the vehicle after all that ordeal, it actually looks pretty good under here. Those shocks are plastic bodied, but they have nice titanium nitride coated shafts, and they work pretty well. But check out my series of build videos for some important tips. The Exo has 3 sealed silicone filled diffs, very much like a 1/8 scale buggy, and all told, with the roll cage removed, it's a very simple, straightforward, and traditional layout. The battery tray is adjustable both lengthwise and in terms of its height to accommodate different sizes of lipos. And the only really weird thing here is that there's no rear shock tower because the shocks actually mount directly to the cage. The motor mount was the source of some controversy early on. They use a sliding carriage, which works kind of like the mount on a low C 8. The motor actually mounts to that slider, and then the whole slider goes in and gets affixed with one single grub screw from the top. During my initial assembly, I found that it was very easy to over-tighten that one grub screw, and if you look very carefully, you'll notice there's a tiny little hairline fracture in the sliding carrier. My bad. Axial actually ended up putting a detailed blog post up explaining the right way to do this. Okay, time to put everything back together. Stopwatch? Check. Naturally, compared to disassembly, reassembly has to take quite a bit longer because you're not able to screw those screws in quite as fast. It also takes time to line up the posts of the roll cage with their holes. Now, I'm sharing with you this pain yet again because it's really important. And this, to me, is the biggest negative of the Axial Exo. When you first start running it and you're trying to figure out what gearing you need, every single time you want to change your pinion, you have to take off the entire cage. You also have to remove the motor entirely. You can't even access the grub screw on the pinion itself without doing all of this. Want to access the signal lead on your ESC to change your drag brake? Off comes the cage. I got plenty of practice doing this, and eventually I actually got my time down under 5.5 minutes. Now for some more pain. Oh yeah, stopwatch again. This time I'm not setting up to show you the chassis or do any work on the vehicle. I'm just installing a battery, a 2S standard sized lipo pack at that. It is a terrible process. Truly annoying. Irritating, aggravating. Again, I actually did an entire video just showing this process. It was actually worth it because it actually requires skill to do this. Everything gets in your way. It sucks. The only way to get around this is to cut out one of the posts of the roll cage and remove the Lexan interior piece altogether. Otherwise, you're going to be cutting up the tops of your fingers every time. Well, after all that pain, imagine my relief when I put this thing on the track for the very first time and it handled like this. This is literally my very first battery pack driving this vehicle. It's almost like it wanted to redeem itself or something. Seriously though, this surprised me in so many ways. First off, this is not at all marketed as a racetrack sort of vehicle. It has radiator detail, for crying out loud, with moving fan blades. The roll cage assembly is also very heavy compared to a standard Lexan body, and it's all up high. Plus, Axial is a company that first made engines and then crawlers. This is their first time making something that goes fast, and it works. With a change of shock oil and tires and nothing else, it works even better. Now, there is no magic involved in the construction of this vehicle, and it cannot outdo the forces of nature and physics. The realistic roll cage does give it a higher center of gravity than a Lexan-bodied RC, so on a high-traction surface with high-traction tires, it will traction roll. Tire-wise, you want to set this up like a team-associated SC10 4x4 with a less aggressive tread up front than in the rear. Or if you want to use the same tread pattern front to rear, just make sure that you use a harder rubber compound up front. With a 550 sized brushless motor, which is what you want to use in this vehicle, the weight balance front to rear is almost perfect. This helps to give it plenty of steering. The only really negative handling characteristic that I notice is that it has a little bit of a tendency to go nose down over jumps, so definitely run it with no drag brake and hold the throttle when you're in the air. In the XO's more natural environment, again, it handled quite well. In this footage, I'm back to using the stock tires, and even though the compound on them isn't very sticky, they did work quite well on this loose stuff. The use of narrower tires up front than in the rear not only gives it a nice scale effect, but it makes the front bite less aggressively. That in turn helps to reduce rollovers. The one nice thing about leaving the Lexan interior piece in place is that it actually has flaps front and rear, as well as having coverage from the top, so not a lot of dust and dirt gets into the chassis itself. Check this out, even on rougher terrain where a buggy really doesn't belong, the XO still was able to get over it pretty well, and it looked good doing it. In all, performance-wise, I really could not have asked for more from the Axial XO. Now, as of the time of this video, I've put between 15 and 20 packs of hard running, full packs, through this car. And yes, I've crashed it a few times, or maybe more than a few times. And yes, I have had things go wrong with it. First of all, one of the shocks busted its cap, popped the cap right off and spilled the oil out. That actually happened two times on two separate occasions, and I was able to just screw it right back in. I also had trouble with the wheel nuts backing themselves off. One time I didn't realize that a nut was almost completely backed off and I kept driving for a full pack with a wheel just wobbling around, and I crushed a wheel bearing. Other than that, nothing has broken so far, not even that motor mount that I cracked while assembling it. So, to sum things up, this Axial XO Terra buggy really tears me apart. My feelings are very mixed. When I'm working on it, I hate it! When I'm driving it, I love it! Every time I had this thing on the track, every single time, people stopped and watched it, not just for a lap or two, but for a good little while. And every time I came off the stand, every single time, people stopped me to talk about just how well it handled. The XO makes me wish I had a pit crew. If I could just drive this thing, it'd be a no-brainer. Let somebody else shuffle those 16 screws and two wheel nuts again and again and again. If after seeing this video, you want to get an Axial XO for yourself, I can't blame you. If after seeing this video, you never want to have an Axial XO for yourself, I can't blame you. But at least now, hopefully, you have what you need to know to make a decision for yourself. And on that note, I bring this one to an end. As always, thank you very much for watching, and please come back again soon for my next video. I'll talk to you then.